I'm Dr. Ben Gaddie, and today we're at the Gaddie Eye Centers in Louisville, Kentucky. Currently, I am the co-chairman of the Vision International Vision Expo conferences and also the executive vice president of the Optometric Glaucoma Society. Our practice is probably very much like many of yours. We have many optometrists in our practice. We have 4 offices, 11 ODs, and about 60 employees. And today I'd like to share with you some of the things around ocular surface disease and blepharitis that can really make a difference in your practice as well. I realized that there was a lot of tolerability issues with the tea tree containing compounds, and the higher the concentration, the more toxicity that patients would feel, either from burning and stinging anywhere to developing an atopic reaction where they would have a lot of flakiness and crusting around the lids, which is really counterproductive to the blepharitis. So from there, I began searching out treatments that were more tolerable and maybe even more effective than what we were using. And that's when I stumbled upon Lenovis and their product Blephadex, which is a patented blend of both tea tree oil and coconut oil. And that combination, which we'll talk about a little bit more later, has been very effective and most importantly, very tolerable for my patients. So I don't have to worry about them going home and having an adverse event, stinging, burning, and just really not being adherent with the therapy because of the side effects from it. We feel like that the coconut oil may also have some acidal effects on the Demodex mites themselves, and it's also a great loosening agent. So as you get the cylindrical dandruff around the base of the eyelashes, which is really pathognomic of Demodex, one of the problems is that cylindrical dandruff blocks the ability of the tea tree oil to get into the follicle and actually have its effect. So what's great about the coconut oil component of it is that it helps loosen all that junk around the lashes, for lack of a better term, and allows us to mechanically remove it and allow the tea tree oil to get in and really have its effect. The second thing, most doctors and patients are starting to learn the benefits of coconut oil in terms of its hydrating effect and its anti-inflammatory effects. This preparation, you could literally pour it into the eye and it has no stinging or negative effects from a comfort standpoint. In fact, many dermatologists are now prescribing coconut oil and different coconut containing preparations for inflammatory skin diseases. So it really makes sense because blepharitis is really a manifestation of a dermatological disease that just impacts the eyelids as well. So it makes a lot of sense to incorporate in the coconut oil, and I think it's a really key component of the efficacy of Blephadex.